Canaan is not for us. I don't believe. I don't know what's going on, but I know it's heaven now. Mm-hmm. No more Canaan. We talking about heaven now.
Amen.
We want eternal life. So they didn't want to hear what he had to say. So they cried out with a loud voice, stopped up their ears, and took Stephen and says out to the edge of the city to stone him. Mm-hmm. And we know that they stoned him until he died. Okay. And so he kneeled down and cried out with a loud voice, Lord, lay not this sin to their charge. And this is how we ought to feel. Love mm-hmm. God so much we can pray in the midst of being stoned, mm-hmm. in the midst of being lied on, mm-hmm. in the midst of being talked about, you mm-hmm. know, and all of these different things that the saints of God being put off your job when you're not the guilty one. That's because right. they want to keep the ones that are living a very horrible lives, mm-hmm. lifestyle, you know, ungodly lifestyles. So the word says they will kill you thinking they are doing God's will. Mm-hmm. Those those were church people who stoned Stephen. Mm-hmm. And this is a sad, very sad part about it. Look who said crucify him. Mm-hmm. The ones, the very ones that should have been loving Jesus.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Can we say praise the Lord?
Mm-hmm.
So this impressed Saul. Mm-hmm. So at that particular time, mm-hmm. who watched them stone Stephen. Okay. And approved of the stoning. He decided to join in with the persecution. But mm-hmm. I'm going to tell you something. He may have been Saul, but when he became Paul, he stopped carrying the coats of those that were being persecuted, and those mm-hmm. that were being imprisoned and all this kind of stuff. But he started preaching himself. That's why Amen. We have to keep on preaching, because we never know mm-hmm. How many Sauls we're going to reach. Amen. Okay? That will become Paul. Can we say amen?
Amen.
So he stood there and watched them as he guarded their coats. It says he went to the proper authorities and got the right papers mm-hmm. to search out and capture everybody right. that he could find calling on the name of Jesus, men and women. Mm-hmm. In Acts chapter 9, and find Paul, it says we find Paul saying threatening words against the disciples of the Lord. By and by, he was a disciple.
Yes.
He found out what it was like to have someone saying derogatory things about you. Mm-hmm. And calling and shooting down your name and his popularity as being the type of soldier that he was in mm-hmm. Rome in Rome. So he decided to go to Damascus to the synagogue, and if he found any of his this way, whether men or women, mm-hmm. he might bring them bound to Jerusalem. Mm-hmm. But you have to watch out, because God awesome. Knows where you are.
Yeah,
he knows where he knows the path you're taking. Mm-hmm. Amen. You just true. Might meet God on that path. You may yeah. meet Jesus, amen.
Amen.
And he might say why. He might call you by your name and say, why persecuted thou me? Mm-hmm. And he'll tell you why what you should not do. Amen. Mm-hmm. And then by he'll tell you what you are to do. Amen. But he's got to get our attention.
Mm-hmm.
Can we say praise the Lord? The Lord is trying to get our attention. Not that way all the time, but he's trying to get our attention. And whatever way he's trying to get it comes through different ways. But let God get your attention. When you hear the voice of the Lord saying, don't do that, you know that's that. You know that's, mm-hmm. don't say it's the devil. If you go out to do something bad and you hear a voice say, don't do that, that's not the voice of the devil.
Mm-mm.
That's God.
Amen.
Amen. We can't say that was the devil that spoke to him on the road to Damascus. Or Damascus. No, that was God. That was Jesus.
Right.
Can we say praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
But something happened that day on that road. Suddenly a light shined from heaven. Amen.
Amen.
Around him, and he fell to the earth. And you heard a voice saying unto him, Saul, Saul, why persecutest thou me? And he said, who art thou, Lord?
Mm-hmm.
He didn't say, who art thou, devil? He says, who art thou, Lord?
Mm-hmm.
And the Lord said, I am Jesus whom thou persecutest. Let me tell you, Jesus will tell you who
mm-hmm.
he is.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Amen. He asked a question, and Jesus says, I am Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
It is hard for thee to kick against the prick. And Saul had a personal encounter with Jesus as a risen mm-hmm. risen Christ. And while he was trying to procure, while he was trying to persecute the believers of Jesus,
mm-hmm.
while he was on pursuit to get papers and to make it right for him, I'll put it like that, to do harm to the people of God, God says, not this time.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. God said, not this time.
Mm-hmm.
So the Lord wants us to, is trying to get our attention so he can help us do right. If you want to do right, God will help us do right.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. If you don't know that you're doing the wrong thing, try to find out the right thing to do.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. We have enough people and saints to get the people that don't know the right thing to do and help them do the right thing. And a lot of times people don't want to listen
mm-hmm.
to you. Even in the church, people sometimes they don't want to listen to you. They'll do all the wrong things, but when they find out it's just not their way of thinking, it's got to be God's way of thinking, that's when they decide perhaps to do right. But this is why we have to keep on making sure that we ourselves, in our time of lack of understanding, that we can go to somebody and say, is this the right way?
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Am I thinking right?
Mm-hmm.
Well, is it right for me to do it this way? You know, and mm-hmm. we have enough help in this church, amen, to help somebody.
Yes.
Can we say mm-hmm. praise the Lord? Definitely mm-hmm. got a pastor yeah. that can help somebody.
Amen.
And guess what? I'm right by myself on his side because I want to help somebody.
Amen.
Can we say praise the Lord? And so we must be aware and prepare for persecution because it's coming, saints.
Mm-hmm.
Matter of fact, it's already come. You already found out.
Mm-hmm.
You may have gotten been saved just a few days, but you find out.
Mm-hmm.
Matter of fact, you find out quickly.
Mm-hmm.
You find out real quick. It's going to come. Amen. Of us, we have, we live for our Savior, Jesus Christ, and God will bless us all the way.
Amen.
So the world that we now live in is becoming more and more hostile, and we know that.
Mm-hmm.
And when the world becomes hostile, and people that are working in a community of sinners and all this kind of stuff, you make sure that hostility don't become attached to you. Amen?
Yeah,
because you'd be surprised. Evil communication corrupts good manner.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to be very careful and not try to, fight. Fight the world,
mm-hmm.
amen. You let God fight for you,
right.
amen.
Mm-hmm.
Give God that battle, amen, because you might lose your job,
right.
amen, trying to fight the person that's coming against you. But you give that situation to God, amen. So we know that we're in a hostile situation here
mm-hmm.
on earth. But whatever comes, we know that God knows how to deliver us out of the hands of the wicked persons,
yes,
of people, okay?
Right.
And so just as he delivered Daniel out of the lion's den, He can deliver us out of our lion's dens, okay, out of trouble.
Mm-hmm.
And just as he delivered the Hebrew boys out of the fire, he can deliver us out of hot situations, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And but as Stephen knew, to live is Christ, to die is gain. We ought to remember that too, to live is Christ, to die is gain. I quote it all the time. And so we don't fear because God has not given us a spirit of fear, but a power of love and a sound mind. Men who can destroy the body, but fear the one, amen?
Mm-hmm.
Fear the one. In other words, and I'm not talking about being a scaredy cat.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Let's reverence God.
Mm-hmm.
You reverence the
mm-hmm.
one. You revere the one who can destroy both soul and body.
Mm-hmm.
And tonight I have a question for you. What can the believer do to prepare for the times of persecution?
Mm-hmm. Pray. Mm-hmm. Pretty much.
A lot of prayer.
Pray always.
Stay with the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Be encouraged by the other examples of faith before. Be encouraged by the other examples of faith before you.
Amen.
Also
amen.
The Lord.
Stay in God's word.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Keep your mind on the Lord,
amen.
And he'll keep your mind in perfect peace,
amen.
Even in the midst of your storm.
Mm-hmm.
Can
amen.
We say praise the Lord?
Praise
keep
Lord.
Your eyes on Jesus. We have to stop looking at our surroundings,
mm-hmm.
things that are going on around us, because it'll get your mind off of the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Amen. So if he's going to keep my mind stayed on him, and he's going to keep my mind
mm-hmm.
in perfect peace, guess what
amen.
I'm going to do? I'm going to keep my mind. I'm going to keep my mind in perfect peace.
Amen.
That's
amen.
What I'm,
amen.
I want my mind to stay on him. That's
amen.
Jesus.
Amen.
Can we say
amen.
Praise the Lord? He is my rock of
amen.
Salvation.
Praise
amen. God. He's my help in time of trouble.
Praise
amen.
Lord.
I'm an ever-present help.
Amen.
Can we say praise the Lord?
Praise
okay,
Lord.
How can a believer explain to an unbeliever why God allowed James to be persecuted and be killed while Peter was persecuted but God spared him?
Everything is according to God's will.
Amen.
Say what?
Everything is according to God's will.
Absolutely. Everything is according to God's will.
Amen.
Anybody else? How can a believer explain to an unbeliever why God allowed James to be persecuted and be killed while Peter was persecuted but God spared him?
I remember Peter was Jesus' friend, and he had given him like a mantle, you know, like he said that this day you would deny me three times, you know. And he lost his mind and all that. And then when he repented, it came back. He had a mission to do. He had to go and bring the word of God, you know, to the world. So I think he had a charge, you know, a higher charge than what James had.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe that could be.
But James still had a charge.
Right. Yes, but
yeah. But the Lord also shows me that God has a reason mm-hmm. doing whatever it is that he does.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. But it was just James's time at that time.
Mm-hmm.
God knows each and all of our personalities.
Mm-hmm.
He knows he knows all of our personalities. Mm-hmm. And so he allowed James to be persecuted and killed while Peter was persecuted, but not, God spared him. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And it was just God's order.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Amen. It was just God's order. We can't try to question it
mm-hmm.
because God knows the mm-hmm. past, present, and the future.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And so since God knows us better than we know ourselves,
mm-hmm.
he knows others better than we know others.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. So whatever way God chose to do that, thank God that he did it. But I
mm-hmm.
believe that when he spared Peter's life
mm-hmm.
and whatever happened after that, I guess God felt that it would be Peter that would be the one to do it.
Mm-hmm.
Anybody else? Anybody else? So let's let God do things his way.
Yeah.
Now, if we're sick, if we're going through something, we want God to deliver us. But sometimes
mm-hmm.
it's like we're just going to keep on going, you know, and like look like a deliverance is not going to. But God knows.
Mm-hmm.
You'd be surprised what God is sparing you from.
Amen.
Right.
when he take you away from here.
Mm-hmm.
You'd be surprised.
Amen.
You know. Well, what are some of the reasons believers are being persecuted in the day that we live in? What are some of the reasons believers are being persecuted in the day that we live in?
They do things differently. We do things differently. We follow the word, and the world follows things that the world does. And so even though it may not be where they'll say, okay, don't, you know, believe in Jesus, or you're getting persecuted because of Jesus, is more so, well, why do you do things that way?
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's I guess nowadays a form of bullying,
mm-hmm.
you know, you do things differently and they feel like you're better,
mm-hmm.
or
They think you're thinking you're better.
Right. Mm-hmm. They
right.
say that, you know, they think they're better than I am, or we are.
Mm-hmm.
You know.
Well, the devil is our enemy.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
And if you're not following God, you're following the devil.
Mm-hmm.
That's true.
And so he's trying his best to kill, steal, and destroy us.
Right.
We can't agree with the devil.
Right.
Exactly.
At any time. You never agree. It sounds sometimes look like it might be your way to get out of this, and it may not be your way. Matter of fact, you might die quicker.
Mm-hmm.
So let's stay with the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
If you stay with the Lord, to live is to Christ, to die is gain.
Amen.
Can we say praise
Amen.
The Lord?
Praise
so some of the reasons believers are being persecuted in the day that we live in, and like she was saying, we know that we're living, but a lot of the believers are not totally acting according to God's will.
Right.
And so it's causing there's confusion there.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. And the world may not realize that you're believing God for what you're saying,
mm-hmm.
but whenever Jesus spoke, he always had that God wisdom,
mm-hmm.
you know, and he would not say things really to stir them up,
mm-hmm.
you know. I was reading when he was talking to Pilate,
mm-hmm.
you know, and I thought, oh, but Jesus knew he was gonna die anyway,
mm-hmm.
amen.
Yeah.
And if Pilate hadn't been so short circuited,
mm-hmm.
see, a lot of people today are short circuited
mm-hmm.
that are in the church.
Mm-hmm.
There's a wire that has come loose in that's
mm-hmm.
that rat.
Mm-hmm.
Something's gone wrong. I have a light mm-hmm. over my bed. That we want to read by or get a little extra light,
mm-hmm.
that we can hear it boiling almost. Sounds like it's cracking and everything. I said, oh, turn that light off because it sounds like it's about to blow up, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But the thing is, we have to make sure that we're trying to turn off trouble.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Amen. And if we have to do whatever it is to turn it off, you turn it off, but
mm-hmm.
you turn it off within you
mm-hmm.
first. Make
mm-hmm.
sure that there's that trouble, that they're trying to trouble that spirit.
Mm-hmm.
You shut it down, you,
mm-hmm.
because you're soaring now into the faith of God,
mm-hmm.
and believing God is going to take care of whatever it is. And if that doesn't happen,
mm-hmm.
just let God have his way.
Yeah.
He had his way with Peter and James.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
If he did it with Peter and James, who are we? Mm-hmm. God is telling us as an individual to trust him.
Amen.
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 Praise the Lord. Yes.
Well, I know, like, what was happening currently with Christians that own real estate, okay? Mm-hmm. And it's very severe, and it's some kind of overt or covert, I should say, covert. They will use code enforcement throughout all of the United States to literally pinpoint a problem in a property. And it's like, what about the property next door whose fence is falling off and everything else, but you're going to write me up and whose fence is not falling off, or the grass is too high, or the shed needs to be done, or any little thing. Mm-hmm. So they'll use the code enforcement. One pastor, in Maryland was telling me that he has a court date because his 8-unit property was written up by court enforcement. I said, oh, they're doing that to me. You know, I'm in, you know, North Carolina. And I have all this real estate. So the more real estate you own, they're going to go after you, especially if you're a Christian. And it's unfair, but it's what is happening.
That's right.
Where everyone else who owns property don't get those letters, don't get those written up. And so it's a form of harassment. And it's very severe to the point that they'll take your property away from you. A lot of Christians have lost their property because they say they owe too much taxes, or they send them a tax bill all of a sudden. And you're a church, you're tax exempt. Why am I paying tax? I had to go through that, and I wrote to, Trump appointed a secretary over the church treasury, I wrote to him. As soon as the day is appointed, I wrote him a letter. Said, why am I being taxed when we're a church? We're tax exempt and so forth. So they were like, why is she right there? But sometimes you have to go back. When they come against you, you have to go back with the law of the land.
That's right.
And another write-up I received was my shed needed to be repaired. Well, 2016, Hurricane Matthew came, and North Carolina was slated to be a presidential declare disaster area. And so North Carolina received $20 billion. So all the people's homes and properties, which our home and our apartment was allocated and approved to receive a fund for, they call it the North Carolina Rebuild. And I got written up because the shed was, you know, falling apart. I said, well, it was a disaster. It was a hurricane why the shed is falling apart. Well, you have 160 days to fix it. I like, well, I'm in the program, you know what I'm saying? So even though you do everything that's right, thank God for the hurricane, thank God for being approved, and thank God for filling out the application, because if I didn't have it, I wouldn't have had a leg to stand on. And, you know, so they're doing all kind of things that will be harassment, I would say. It really literally is.
It's
you
amazing.
Know, really is.
It's amazing to see how people are in certain positions seem to have the ability to spend your money.
What's happening in Washington?
When you should be receiving money for repairs.
Oh, Prince George County taking back people. And gentrification. I talked about it, and really, because people don't seem to realize how they're taking people's property from them, you know, and you have rights. I tell everybody, just do a chapter 13, 7, 11, and 10, and 13, and all of them. Because God's word said the year of Jubilee, you know, you can be free and take back, and they cannot touch your properties. But people think that that's a bad thing, but it's not. It's a law that protects you, protects your land, protects all your assets, your car, everything. It cannot touch you when you just fill out that little $300 application and protect all your assets.
Yeah.
No, I'm serious, because what happens in a bankruptcy situation, they give you 5 years to pay the debt, right? And after, you can make income to umpteenth degree during that time. And after that time, I have one friend, he received, after filing 13, he became $6 million, a millionaire, $6 million. How do you
six say times?
He became a millionaire after 13, right?
Six, yeah.
And he kept all his assets and everything else, you know. And it's just that just understanding the law of Jubilee, which was written in Genesis, is for us, the children of God, to protect us.
Mm-hmm.
And there's laws, but if you don't know the laws, then you lose your property, mm-hmm. and they just come. And one of my friends, I couldn't believe it. I mean, I'm talking, she called me, she's in Augusta, Georgia, and she called me, she said, my father is about to lose his land, 200 mm-hmm. acres in Rocky Mountain, North Carolina.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, well, okay, I know what to do to protect it. And she said, oh, he's not going to save you. I said, but do you want to save it or what? And they literally auctioned off his house. They're supposed to do it in the county in Rocky Mountain. They auctioned it off in Tennessee.
Mm.
You know, and the neighbor that was harassing him the whole time got 200 acres of this man's. And he was a military person, Green Beret, you know, honorary discharged. I mean, and they're older people,
mm-hmm.
you know, and they're in their 80s now or whatever. And they just came and just mm-hmm. took all that land away from them.
Now, what I gleaned from what she said is that God let me see that whatever field or subject or whatever it is that of endeavor that we go into, let's make sure that
we learn something, mm-hmm. you know, and study that area of endeavor, mm-hmm. you know, and get some information on it, so we'll know what to do when certain problems come up.
Mm-hmm.
Know the law,
know the law.
The regulations, yes, you know, yes. and we just have to be mm-hmm. careful, but there's things that we have to do to protect ourselves.
Yes.
And knowledge is a great thing, Pastor.
Oh, I wasn't raising my hand, but we have to realize that we're in America.
Yes.
Whether we like it or not, we're blessed.
Yes.
Because
yes.
we have laws to protect us,
yes.
laws to protect our lives. Mm-hmm. Every now
yes.
and then we hear people getting killed.
Mm-hmm.
Amongst racists, not for Christianity.
Mm-hmm.
Right. But we are being persecuted
mm-hmm.
in different ways,
mm-hmm.
in different forms.
Mm-hmm.
We're in a little small hick town here, and we can't get from the bank the percentage that they offer other churches and businessmen.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And I've gone in and actually told them and went through it. And they tried to act like they couldn't do nothing. We'll ask the president, and the president comes out
mm-hmm.
and says, we can't do anything for you. We can go 6%. Well, 6% is not the going rate for churches and business. So we suffer other ways and
mm-hmm.
other means as a result of our religion. We have learned to be quiet and to take it. Thank God. Go on your way. We praise God for what we get because God makes a way.
Yes, He does. Yes,
and so we learn to trust God.
Yes.
But in other countries, they're still killing people.
Oh, yeah, they are.
They're still doing similar to what we're looking at and reading in the Bible.
Mm-hmm.
Because many times these are lands that are not broken in,
mm-hmm.
If you understand what I'm saying.
Right.
People are living in backwards condition,
mm-hmm.
that they don't have laws to protect.
That's right.
And so they're allowed to do things and get away with it.
Mm-hmm.
And so, you know, while you're in America, you can say, praise God.
Amen.
Nothing
Amen.
Happened to me, but we have to remember to pray for those who are from this country,
right.
who are going to spend their life, spend their time, their tour, to spread the gospel, who will be confronted with death constantly.
Mm-hmm.
That's right.
And so as we think in the book, we look at the big book it talks about, it asks a question, what are some of the reasons believers are not being persecuted in the day? Again, we have to say the law protects us in the country,
mm-hmm.
this country.
That's right.
But if we go into other countries, we'll find the same thing is still going on.
Because
time is not that great,
mm-hmm.
that different. You know,
mm-hmm.
sometimes you think of who you are, where you are,
mm-hmm.
Your great-grandfather, live in times of slavery and all
mm-hmm.
this kind of stuff. Just, you know, a few generations
That's right.
From where we are now. We're still talking, there was an article about the last man who lived through slavery in the newspaper. And so it's not that far. But again, because we have laws that protect us, these are the things that's going on. All it takes is one man to try to change all the laws. One man to speak up and tell people to kill. You'll find a whole letter, a whole matter, the situation changes, the complexity of it. And in the last year or so with Trump in, we see the country changing. We see the the attitude of people. We do things that say I'm not prejudiced, but history shows that we are prejudiced in what we do. And this is where the value of prayer comes in. We pray that God will be with us, he'll bless us, and trust God. The object is to hold on to the Lord.
Amen.
God said he would not allow anything to happen to you that you cannot bear.
Amen. Amen.
If we want to look at the mind of God and try to predict the mind of God as to why this one died and that one didn't die, God is the judge of that.
Yes.
We don't even have a right to question God because we're all different. And so when these things, sometimes things are said and done to create doubt in our mind. But we have to stand firm on faith and to walk with God. We trust and we pray for our health and our strength. At the same time, we're prepared to die for the cause of Christ.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Can we say praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
We are saints of God in here tonight. We are to be an example.
That's
can we say
right.
praise the Lord? In 2 Timothy 3 and 10 to 70, it says, but thou hast fully known, amen, my doctrine, manner of life, purpose, faith, long-suffering, charity, patience, persecutions, afflictions, which came upon me at Antioch and Iconium and Lystra, what persecution I endured. But out of them all, the Lord delivered me.
Amen.
Yea, and all that shall live godly, this is all, it said, yea, and all that will live godly in Christ Jesus shall suffer persecution. But evil men and seducers shall wax worse and worse. And we talked about this, deceiving and being deceived. But he tells us and encourages us tonight through in the word. Amen. Through our brothers that have gone on. It says, but continue thou in the things which thou hast learned and hast been assured of, knowing of whom thou hast learned them, and that from a child thou hast known the Holy Scriptures,
Amen.
Which are able to make thee wise unto salvation through faith, which is in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. All Scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness, that the man of God, that's the woman too, hallelujah, that the man of God may be perfect, praise God, thoroughly, thoroughly furnished, amen, unto all good works.
Amen.
Let's live holy and do the work of the Lord.
Yes.
God
amen.
Is soon to return, and I want to be ready. Do you want to be ready?
Amen.
I want to be ready.
Amen.
I want to be ready when he comes. We sing that song, Be Ready When He Comes.
Amen.
Let's take that advice, be ready when he comes.
Amen.
We thank God tonight for our lesson and all those that participated in the answering, the conclusion, the answering and should I say the Q&A?
Questions.
The Q&A, amen. The questions and answers tonight. And we just praise God for you being here tonight. Lord, all of us. Do you love us?
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Do you love one another?
Yes.
Each of us, we love each other.
Hallelujah.
I love you. If you don't love me, don't you dare die. And I better not die, right? Yeah, I better not die. Not loving our brothers and our sisters, but I love my brothers and my sisters tonight. And truly, God loves us more than we can ever love each other.
Amen.
So let's stick with the love of God because it will just keep us growing. And we shall abound. Amen.
Amen.
And so, let's see.
Omit the reading.
Praise the Lord. Okay, we're going to omit the reading of the minutes tonight. Okay, and we're just going to move on. And I just thank God for you all that are present here. And without any more to say, we're going to put in to ask our pastor just to dismiss us. And we're going to, this is what he's about to do is actually part of a lesson tonight. Mm-hmm. And so we thank God for his, we're going to prayer and read his home.
You have a minute?
No, not tonight. Let's say amen for Bishop Stovall.
Amen.
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 Y'all set?
Yeah.
We'll let him read in a minute. You?
We haven't said
no?
Okay. We haven't done a book, so yeah.
All right then. Sure, we thank God for the blessings of the Lord, and always in my mind, do things for protection, not just through routine. So, but we thank God for the word of God that we've heard tonight. Just as a closing remark, we have to be prepared. And sometimes we're going through things and we have become so used to it until we settle for it. But we are being mistreated. And many times because of our religion. I went to the bank to cash a check. I sat in the car 5-10 minutes waiting for them to cash my check. I said to the lady, I said, are you having trouble with the check? Oh, no. And then they sent the money in. But this other car come in and go. I'm sitting in the window watching them. And I had 3 women wait on me. For no reason, we go through these things, but we sort of get used to it. So we don't, say too much about it. Of course, we get fed up, then you go in and you let them know exactly what's going on and threaten to move your money out of the bank and all these things, and they make sure that you're not mistreated. But things are going on, and don't think they are. And a lot of things are happening. You're still being kept out of areas. Your ministry is still being pushed in the back because you're a Christian, because you believe in the Bible.
Right.
And never think that it'll never be a time that you will have the gospel will go freely and nobody's going to bother you. It's prophetic. You shall have trials and tribulations.
Amen.
Okay?
Amen.
Amen. I was talking to somebody today, I don't know who it was, and I said to him, don't tell me nothing about you not going through nothing. Everything is all right. You going through something, or else you have already been had. Everybody's going through
that's
things.
That's what we've been bought.
Let's stand. I'll let you go.
And that's what the price is. Everybody stand, he said.
Praise the Lord. Eternal Father, we love you and we thank you again for your goodness and your mercy, for the love of God that rests within our hearts and our souls. We thank you for your word today to remind us that we must be firm in the faith and we must continue to live for you and walk with you each and every day. Prepare to live as Christ, to die as gain. Be with us and strengthen us that we might stand in this evil day.